Okay, so welcome to this fourth part of a series of presentations of the ProQuest database early English books online. So, in this final presentation, I'm going to show you how to browse the contents of this database. So let me click on Browse. So, to start with, you can browse alphabetical lists of all the authors in the database. Now, this depends on what you have access to at your institution. So, you may have a subscription to the database ECHO, so 18th Century Collection Online from Gale. And if you do, you can connect the two databases and browse all those authors in one go. It may also be that your institution is a member of the Text Creation Partnership. So that means that you have access to rekeyed full texts for some books in Early English Books Online. And if you do, you can check for which authors are there rekeyed full text, where you can search all the words in the text. And if not, just browse all the authors in this database. As you notice, at least on top of this list, there are there may be acronyms for authors, also different pseudonyms, as you notice. But you can also search for author names, of course. So let's a famous author, Francis Bacon. So I could just write Bacon if I wish, click the button, and then this name in red is simply the first person alphabetically called Bacon. But the one I'm looking for is Francis Bacon. And there's 204 books. And there are the records. Again, there may be duplicates, because there may be different editions, interesting, important differences between different copies of the same book. And you will then see the author name, the title, the date, where the physical original copy is placed at which library. Your institution may be subscribing to the database Literature Online from ProQuest. If you do, you can connect these databases and get more information about the author from Literature Online. And then for each record, you have, as I've already explained in the earlier parts of this series of presentations, there are icons, the tools. So this first one will take you to the full record of this book. This will take you to the very first page or pages, and then you can browse the book page by page. And this button will take you to thumbnails, showing all the scanned pages of this book. And again, you can click on any thumbnail to get the whole page. And again, you have tools for zooming the page. And you can also download it in different formats, PDF and TIFF. So that's browsing the authors. You can also browse what's called the Thomason Tracts. So I can recommend that you read the About page when starting to use Early English Books Online. Then you can read more details about the Thomasson collection or the Thomasson tracts. But Thomasson was a person that lived in England during 1640s, 1660s, and who simply collected pamphlets, books, newspapers, and so on. And when you search the database, Basic Advance, search periodicals, you are searching this collection. But from here, you can also browse the whole collection as it was collected, as it says in the description. So you can, for instance, do like this, and let's have a look there. And there you can see the collection. So let me just pick an example. Click there. It's called the Spy Communicating Intelligence from Oxford. And again, the tools for zooming and saving in different formats. So browsing the Thomasson tracts. And then finally, you can browse the periodicals. And again, I can recommend that you have a look at help when searching periodicals. And then you can get to know more about what types of periodicals are available in the database. So the Corantos between 1620 and 1621, and then the news books. So browsing periodicals, 1620, December, and there's the Corantos. And then 1640, April, and there the so-called news books. Okay, so that was how to browse the ProQuest database, Early English Books Online. So thank you very much for watching and listening. Bye.